today on Midday at 12:30. It is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and Dillard's is here to tell us about their Fit for the Cure initiative, created to raise funds to support breast cancer research.
Plus, resident chef Allison Davis is cooking up a meatless Mexican dish that your entire family will love. This is Midday Kentucky at 12:30.
Good afternoon. Happy Tuesday. Thanks for joining us on Midday at 12:30. I'm Amber Freeman.
And I'm Adam Banks.
How you feeling, Adam?
Feeling good. Just trying to get my body adjusted to these new cold temperatures that we're having.
See, I love when the locals say it's cold, because our meteorologist, George Zabrecki, was giving me a hard time the entire news last night at 5:30 about it being cold.
Well, the cold typically doesn't bother me. It's just so daggone cold in the morning times, because I crank the air conditioner up before I go to sleep, and then when I wake up, I'm freezing to death.
Ah, so basically it's your own fault.
No. It is. I got to make adjustments.
I'm just kidding. A lot of people are very happy because they can break out the sweater weather. No.
Sweaters for the weather. That's what they can break out. Hoodies.
The cold makes my brain freeze. and all that kind of stuff. And it feels more fall-like. Yes. All that kind of stuff.
You can feel it in the air, but I can't drink my coffee on the porch in the morning times because it's too cold. So it's a catch-22. It's all about that experience of
first,
drinking the coffee.
First world problems. I think you could probably still make that happen. Wouldn't that counteract? Did you do any kind of fall activities? Do you decorate your house for fall?
I do not, but I'm a big Halloween person, so I'm all about putting up. Well, the cobwebs are kind of natural, but I am all about putting up some Halloween decorations.
So do you carve a pumpkin?
I do. Haven't yet, but I plan on doing that.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm hoping to maybe do that on the show. I can't really say that I'm talented at that.
Make sure that I'm here. I can help you out with that.
Okay.
I'm not good at many things, but carving the jack-o'-lanterns, I'm an ace.
We will try that. All right, I don't know if you've heard about this new craze. I don't even know if it's called a craze. It's something that is happening in London right now at a very posh bar. Whiskey maker Glenlivet has released edible cocktail capsules. Now, they're made from seaweed, and they're kind of like a jello shot. And I hate saying this, they look like the Tide Pod, so it's kind of like that hybrid. Now, you don't need a glass, you don't need any ice, you do not need a cocktail stirrer. Whiskey lovers simply pop one of these candy-like pods in their mouth, and apparently you can either bite down or you can just swallow it, so.
And it says that they come in three flavors, citrus, wood, and spice. The elixirs were crafted by legendary London cocktail connoisseur. Each capsule contains 23 millimeters of liquid and measures just under an inch.
So that means you have to have more than one to kind of, they look big, to equal one drink. But the seaweed casing comes from a partnership with a sustainable packaging startup, so I guess they're good for you. Currently, the boozy buttons are made especially for London Cocktail Week, where they're going to be served until this, I guess, Sunday, the 13th. But apparently they could be making their way to us soon. What do you think of these?
Just like drinking coffee, it's all about the experience. This takes away the experience of socially drinking your alcohol, because you might as well just go ahead and hook an IV up to you and get to the main point of drinking alcohol, getting it in your system. This takes away from the experience. It's just a quick hit.
I agree with you, but I don't think majority of people maybe agree with you that drinking alcohol is about the experience. I know college kids definitely aren't, so this might just be a quick way. The person who made this, who I think is a creator of Glenlivet, whoever's in charge of it right now, says that's not his intention with these pods. He's not saying, yay, now you can sneak these into the game, or you can sneak these in, you don't have to hide a flask anymore. He said he's just trying to do something kind of new and kind of cool.
Yeah, I think it's, like you said, it's perfect for sneaking in games and stuff. That's a sports fan's
dream. But is that really the experience, Mr. Cocktail Connoisseur?
You got me there. You did get me there. But, you know, Gen Z is loving this, because remember that whole craze with the Tide Pods when they were eating the laundry detergent? So leave it to the Gen Z to put this out there. Well, no, the owner is a little bit older, isn't he?
Well, yeah, because, and these are like, I don't know, it's like the London bars, they are very, very, very big on their cocktails and making everything really, really cool. And I feel like the cocktail world has just expanded into where it really is this art, mm-hmm. where it's whoever can make the craziest cocktail concoction, and it is about the experience for them. This, I don't know what it's new. We're talking about it.
Yeah, I think it's just a creative idea, something to put out to test the waters. It's not made its way to the U.S. just yet, but I think it would catch on.
I'm wondering if they're going to use other liquors and not put Glenlivet in them, because if people are going to try and sneak those in the games, I think they're going to go for the cheaper versions.
So it's a capsule. It reminds me of those little Tylenol capsules when you bite down and you get the medicine once you bite down. I have a hard time swallowing those. They get stuck in my throat, so I'm afraid that if I swallow those.
We're going to have to talk about these capsules during the break, because I'm not quite sure what you're talking about. I thought you just swallowed them.
You're supposed to, but they're big horse pills, so they're easy to get stuck in your throat.
Then you need to make your drink. All right. Thank you, Adam. Stay with us. We have more to come after the break. We're going to talk breast cancer awareness, research, and how you can help. We'll be right back.